Hey Braves fans, Kevin McAlpin here, your Truist reporter for The Fan and the Atlanta Braves Radio Network. Hope you're having a great start to your week. It's Monday, September the 14th. Braves are in Baltimore, gearing up for a three-game interleague series against the Orioles starting tonight at 7:35 p.m. Eastern. Couple of right-handers going at it. Tuki Toussaint on the mound for the Braves, and he'll be opposed by Jorge Lopez on the mound for the Baltimore Orioles. Of course, Tuki Toussaint added back to the Braves roster today. Sean Newcomb sent back to the alternate training site at Gwinnett. First time we've seen Tuki in the big leagues in about 3 weeks since he was sent back down. And of course, he'll be looking for his first win of the season. Toussaint's 0-1 with a 7.89 earned run average. He'll be taking on Lopez. Jorge Lopez 1-0 on the year with a 6.38 ERA. For Tuki Toussaint, a couple things to keep an eye on here tonight. Of course, that slider has been a much improved pitch for him here in 2020. Changeup and fastball and the curveball, of course, are other pitches he relies on quite a bit. That fastball command at times has been really good and at other times has been spotty to say the least. So we'll see if he's able to get ahead and attack with that fastball and then mix in his secondary stuff here tonight against Baltimore. First time we've seen him again in about 3 weeks here at the big league level. Brian Snitker said earlier today that the team has been working on some mechanical adjustments for Tuki. Remember, in spring training, he was more over the top with his delivery. Something he tried to improve upon, making some adjustments during spring training. So we'll see if that's able to translate. And that's probably something I'm sure he worked really hard to get back on track with here over his last couple of weeks at Gwinnett. Of course, on Saturday night, Braves got just a tremendous pitching performance from Ian Anderson. Yesterday, Kyle Wright, his first career win in the big leagues. For the Braves, it marked the third time this season a pair of Braves pitchers have gone at least six innings in consecutive starts this year. Max Fried and Ian Anderson did it in that doubleheader against the Yankees on August the 26th. And Tuki Toussaint and Kyle Wright did it on August 6th and 8th on back-to-back ball games for the Braves. So, of course, they'll look for Tuki to hopefully build on what a couple of young arms have accomplished. Seven scoreless innings from Ian Anderson Saturday. And then, like I said, Kyle Wright, if you just look at his line, three earned, four runs, six hits, it might not blow you away. But I thought he showed some big-time signs of progress in yesterday's outing, and nobody had to enjoy that post-game celebration more than Kyle Wright. So congratulations to him on his first career win. For the Braves offensively, of course, Freddie Freeman's been one of the hottest hitters in all of baseball. He has hit safely in 26 of his last 27 contests. He's batting .396 over that stretch going back to August the 14th. Of course, he had a double in yesterday's ballgame. That was the 355th two-base hit of his career. He moved within four of passing Hall of Famer Eddie Mathews for third most on the franchise all-time list. Of course, Hank Aaron has 600, Chipper Jones had 549, and Freddie Freeman 335 for his career. The Braves are getting set for an interleague series here again tonight. They're 9-5 against the American League this season. Braves have only been involved in sweeps at American League ballparks this season. They lost both games in Tampa, and then, of course, they were swept in New York by the Yankees, but then they went back and swept the Red Sox at Fenway Park. So it's been nothing but sweeps in interleague ballparks for the Braves this season. Of course, yesterday they took 3 out of 4 from the Washington Nationals. They'll enter play tonight with a 3.5-game lead in the East over the Miami Marlins. That's right. The Marlins took both games of that doubleheader from Philadelphia yesterday, and they still have one more to go. This is the 7th game in 5 days between those two teams, featuring a couple of doubleheaders in South Florida. Again, the lead for the Braves now with less than 2 weeks to go, 3.5 over the Marlins and 4 over the third place Phillies. As far as what's to come this week, we still do not know who will start tomorrow. Snit said he's got an idea of what he's thinking about doing for game 2 tomorrow. We will find out following the game. So hopefully you'll join me for the Hyundai postgame show on the Braves Radio Network, and we will all find out together who will take the mound for the Braves. If I have to guess, I'll say Waskari Noah is probably the guy who will get the ball in game 2. We do know Cole Hamels will start game 3 on Wednesday against Baltimore. Snit said today that Max Fried could have gotten that nod, but again, with the built-in day off and with the reinforcement of Cole Hamels being healthy and ready to go, they're just going to give Max Fried those extra couple of days. He feels fine. He's undergoing treatment. He's throwing all the normal in-between start activities. So Max Fried, good to go, and we'll see him Friday night at Citi Field as the Braves take on the Mets for their final road series of the season. We'll be on the air with the Ford Leadoff Show tonight at 6:15 p.m. Eastern. That'll be Ben, Buck, and Chris, They'll walk you up to first pitch. Jim and Joe have all the action. And then stick around immediately following the game for the Hyundai postgame show with yours truly. And then Braves wrap up locally here in Atlanta, where we will talk about hopefully a Braves W over the Orioles. Braves and O's coming up from Oriole Park at Camden Yards tonight. Hopefully you'll join all of our coverage on the Braves Radio Network and right here on 680thefan.com and all of our social media outlets at 680thefan.